submit meu speech.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. Who speech is it?
Okay. You are giving the team for the speech contest.
Yeah, I'm not here.
I won't
be here. I just gave it. Dinesh is giving it, I will give it.
Okay. You practice for tomorrow?
A little bit. By tonight, I'll come. So, tomorrow, who are you going? Yeah, I'm
going. Okay.
So, we'll meet at what time?
9 o'clock you guys are supposed to report.
Message me.
Yes, I am back. Welcome to Christmas. What are you doing?
I'm T. What's that?
TTM.
You are the dummy.
You are the dummy.
You are?
Are you giving speech?
You are giving speech.
You will do?
Accounter?
Accounter. TTS at the TTM, you will give me one copy.
Get me with that accounter copy. किसी और को डांस कर देता मीटिंग 173
Or do you want to count it as a CC?
So I'm glad you could all make it on the Saturday evening where we had a choice of partying or sleeping. Actually I was just sleeping and Ryan called me up and reminded me that we have a meeting actually. So once again I welcome you all to Toastmasters Club meeting 173. So Toastmasters is about improving your public speaking and leadership skills, and we follow a set of rules for in this process. The first rule being we do not speak about sex, religion and politics. Secondly, we keep our phones in silent mode so as to not disturb. distract the audience on the group. I would like to give you 20 seconds for doing that. Thirdly, if any sort of communication is required, please do so using the form of chits and do not talk among yourselves. So with this, I would like to call upon the presiding officer of the day, Toastmaster Ryan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jeevan. Life is full of unexpected stuff. Usually we have meetings on Thursdays, but for some reason, this halls were blocked and we ended up on a Saturday, experimenting how well a Saturday would work for a Toastmasters meeting. And apparently it bombed. So I welcome all of you who have taken the efforts to come on a Saturday evening, especially the guests we have. We have two guests over here. Could you just briefly introduce yourself to the group?
Hi everyone, this is Neha and I'm a student here in DOMS first year.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. I hope you would enjoy this meeting. And without further ado, I would like to declare the 173rd meeting open. To begin with, every Toastmasters meeting is run and directed by a person who is called the Toastmaster of the Day. He or she decides what happens throughout the meeting and rather how the meeting is continues, and they ensure the smooth flow of the meeting. And today's Toastmaster of the Day is a pretty silent person, but you know what we say, we call in Hindi Chupa Rustam, if you understand. So I would like to call the Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Dheeraj.
So I'm the Toastmaster today, and I will take care of all the things that happened today in Toastmasters. Toastmasters meeting has three different sections. The first section has a prepared speech where a Toastmaster member will be given a topic in advance with some given agendas and the given learning points that he wants to learn. And he will come here with a prepared speech and deliver his prepared speech in the given time. And we'll have an allotted evaluator who will see if he has achieved the prescribed learning points and guide him for the future. The second part of the Toastmaster meeting is the table topics meeting. As the name suggests, the topics that people, including the guest as well as Toastmaster members, will be called upon at random and will be given a topic on the stage, and you have to speak for a topic for around 1 to 2 minutes. And the third part of the Toastmasters is an evaluation session where the evaluators come and evaluate the speakers and give them the guidance. So we have one prepared speech and one more speech as a preparation for the humorous speech contest that is happening by Jeeva. Next we'll have the table topic session, and then we'll go for the evaluation session. So every Toastmaster meeting will have one theme and one word of the day. So this time we have theme as time, and word of the day will be given by the grammarian. We encourage the speakers to use the word of the day as much as possible during their speech. So without taking much of the time, I would like to call the general evaluator to come on stage and tell his story.
Good evening, everyone. I will be playing the role of general evaluator for today's this afternoon's meeting. As a general evaluator, it's my responsibility to monitor the entire proceeding and give my report at the end of the meeting. To help me with evaluation, I have something called the TAC team. The TAC team comprises of the grammarian, the timer, and the R counter. And to let you know what each role is, I would like to call each of them and request them to release their roles. First, I would like to call the R counter for today's meeting, Toastmasters.
Yeah. Myself, Soumen. I am the accounter for today's meeting. The purpose of accounter is to note words and sounds used by the speakers during the meeting. Also, I will note the sounds such as ah, and er, and unnatural pauses that do not form a part of the speech. Finally, my role would include noting repetitive words or phrases by a speaker. I shall submit my report when called upon by the general evaluator. Thank you.
Next, I would like to call the timer for today's meeting, Toastmaster Pranchu.
Fellow Toastmasters and guests, as a timer, my duty is to prepare time to prepare speeches, tabletop speeches, and speech evaluation during this meeting. During the prepared speech session, when a speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, I'll show the green card. When the speaker reaches the midpoint of the minimum time allotted, I will show the amber card. And when the speaker reaches the end of his speaking time, I'll show the red card. At this point, the speaker has exactly 30 seconds to close the speech. During the table topic session, at the end of a minute, I'll show the green card. At the end of a 1 minute and 30 seconds, I'll show the amber card. And at the end of the 2 minutes, I'll show the red card, beyond which the speaker has to finish up his speech within 30 seconds. At the end of the meeting, I will submit my report and call upon. Thank you. Over to you, Chief.
Thank you, Pranjal. I am playing the role of grammarian for today's meeting. As a grammarian, it's my role to observe and note the use of English language by the speaker during the meeting. I shall note and appreciate the use of rhetorical tools like dyads, triads, metaphors, etc. I shall also note the phrases or sentences that use incorrect or inappropriate English. Also, it is my responsibility to note the number of times the word of the day is used by each person who comes forward to talk. The word of the day for today's meeting is Jiffy. So, J-I-F-F-Y, if that's not correct. So, Jiffy means very soon or in a second. So, if you are using it in a second, in a sentence, you will say like when a friend calls up and you have to say that I'll be there in a short while, you say I'll be there in a jiffy. So, that's how you can use it in a sentence. So I would encourage everyone who comes forward to talk, use it as many times as possible in their speeches. And at the end of the meeting, I should submit my grammarian report when called upon by the general evaluator. So I, as a general evaluator, will submit my report at the end of the meeting.
Now we'll go to the prepared speech section without taking much of time. So we have Toastmaster Jeevan prepared for his speech contest. So before going to his speech, I would like to bring a bit of Toastmaster. Toastmaster is an international organization. Toastmaster organization is spread across several countries, and they have a lot of contest in our division level, contest in area level, and then finally at the contest of international level. So one of such contests is humorous speech contest. Last week, 15 days ago, we had a humorous speech contest within our club, and Toastmaster Jeevan was one of the members who got selected, and he will be preparing. He has prepared a speech and is going to the next level tomorrow, and he's gonna give his speech today, and I would like to call him upon the stage for a speech. Math department, Toastmaster Jeevan. Are they for math department?
So I'm doing my master's in the electrical department, and I was sitting in my lab doing some work, and one day my guide came to me and said, "Jeevan, you go to the maths department today, there's a seminar today, you go attend it, take notes of it and come back and explain me." I was like, okay, cool, fine, not that bad. And I went to the maths department, I entered the seminar hall, and I saw a very beautiful girl sitting right in front of me. She was wearing sleeveless and shorts, and there was no one sitting next to her. And then I started to think to myself, should I sit next to her or not? Then I started to ask myself, see, if I sit next to her, I cannot focus, I'll be distracted, and I cannot make notes, and in this case, I cannot explain to my guide, it'll all be a downfall. So after jotting down all these points, I finally decided to go and sit next to her. So I went and sat next to her. Right next to me, right side of me, a guy came and sat. He introduced himself saying he's from MBA Finance. MBA Finance guy in Math Department. This is like crazy. Okay, fine, let's be okay. So then the seminar started. The Max professor entered the stage. He was actually very bald, probably too much of Max over his head. Then the seminar started. First slide, he started with 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. I was thinking to myself, I might be smart after all. I'm understanding Max. Second slide, started with, we know that the triple integral of the double differential of sine of the cos of the tan of the square of the cube of the fourth power of x is equal to 1. I understood the right hand side part. And in spite of all these things, I had to do one thing. I had to make notes of whatever that guy is telling and then explain it to my brain. It was like collecting coding from everywhere myself and then jumping into it face first. Somehow I managed to write notes, and even that girl was writing notes. But that is not the problem with her. That girl, full body spray. Like one entire bottle of body spray she had put in her. Like no value for money at all. See, if I had all buy a body spray, I'll use it for minimum 6 months. My dad bought a body spray when he got married. He's still using it. There's even written a will and kept. In case I die, please pass this on to my dear son. Okay. So then I was fully distracted. I still somehow managed to write notes, as I told, and even she was writing notes. And in that gap, what happened suddenly, the speaker, the math professor, stupid fellow, he started changing slides very fast. And she missed a few lines to write, but I had written those lines. And she was sitting to the left side of me. She bent a little towards the right to see my notes. And at that point, her right arm touched my left arm. Sleeveless also, direct contact, clean cold. I went blank for 5 minutes. And just continued the entire session. For every one line she missed, I missed my entire paragraph. But still, somehow, managed to write notes and move on. But if you guys still remember, there was one more sad soul sitting next to me. MBA Finance. Math department people are only not understanding. He went to coma, half size off. Now what happened in between the seminar was, he removed his paper and kept, and someone from the back mistakenly kicked it off. And he started searching for his paper in the middle of the seminar. He was like, where is my paper? Fully frustrated he was, fully anger. And myself, I am beside, I am fully in tension because I missed a lot of lines because of the girl. No, I have to explain it to my guide also. And in that gap, this fellow is like calling me and asking, "Sala, mera slipper kahan hai?" I felt like taking the same slipper and slapping him. But then, somehow, seminar got over at 12 o'clock in the noon. Whatever notes I had written, I took it and I went to my guide and said, "Sir, math department is very challenging. but I managed to write something and come. To which he replied, the seminar I sent you is at 4 o'clock evening. Which seminar did you attend? I came out of the office. I took both my slippers and slapped myself. What have I done? What have I done? But then I had no other choice. I went to the seminar at 4 o'clock, after which I also became psycho and got MBA finals. That evening, I went to psychologist to repair myself. In fact, I met MBA finals also there. Family reunion. I went to him and said, in happiness, hi. He turned back and replied, Sala, there is slipper kaale. Somehow this incident passed 1 week over. After 1 week, my brain had become normal and I came back to lab and I was doing my experiment. Suddenly my guide came and said, Jeevan, there is a seminar in maths department. You go attend it. I changed my mind. Back to you, Toastmaster.
That was, in fact, an entertaining speech. There are three important things that you need for every humorous speech. And every stand-up comedian has them. But those three things are banned in Toastmasters. And with that note, giving a humorous speech should give a big hands of applause for Jeevan. So next we have a prepared speech by Toastmaster Dinesh. So without taking much time, I'll hand over the stage to him. Toastmaster Dinesh, push the ground and pull the rope. Push the ground and pull the rope, Toastmaster Dinesh.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dinesh. I guess every one of us gets stuck in life at some point in their life. Even I was stuck a month ago, both physically and mentally, trying to conquer my fears of height, water, and the fear, and most importantly, the fear of death. I was trying to figure out what to do next when I realized that the only way out was to push the rope, push the ground, and pull the rope. In a very similar fashion, years ago, my teacher started the class by banging the board and caught everyone's attention. He brought up a very simple topic of tug of war. I hope every one of you have played the game of tug of war. He brought up the topic of tug of war to explain to us a very simple concept of Newton's third law. Now, Newton's third law seems to be very simple. It states that every action has an equal and opposite reaction to it. But on that particular day, he made the lecture seem a bit complicated for me. Because he had, like every experienced professor does, tried to give us a philosophical approach to this third law. That lecture was very complicated and for me, much of a puzzle. I was unable to figure out what he was trying to say. The only thing that I took away from that lecture was that whenever you push or pull an object, the you receive a push or pull in return. But the way he said, or the penultimate judgment that he gave on Newton's third law was that when you push, that the only reason we have been given the ability to apply forces to the object around us is not to move these things around, but rather to receive a force in return which moves us in the correct direction in our life. On that day, I didn't understand anything. But years later, that lecture still remains etched in my brain because I'm still trying to solve what he wanted to tell me. Years later, just a month ago, I went on a trip to Kerala. Now, Kerala is a wonderful state. Beautiful waterfalls, beautiful scenery everywhere. And this time, I went to a place called Minmuti Waterfalls to visit the place and enjoy the nature around it. There, my guide told me that in order to reach the waterfall, you are supposed to climb the Rocky Mountain, which is around 100 meters in height. At first, the task seemed to be very simple. I had to climb those rocks and reach the peak to see the waterfall. But in no time, I realized that I had started to climb the mountain with my slippers on. After climbing a few feet, I realized that my slippers had started to slip and I had already slipped twice on my climb up. Now, there I was, standing beside a waterfall, totally paralyzed, trying to understand, trying to figure out what should I do next. If I slip, then I will fall and I will die. Spot them. It was very clear. They had given us ropes to climb the mountain. But the problem is that you can use the ropes only to climb up and not down. And the second bigger problem was that the rocks which I was climbing on, they were getting steeper and steeper. So, after standing at that particular spot, for the next 15 minutes, I decided that somehow I had to get out of this situation. So, I pulled myself together and I decided that if I had to go up, then the only way out was to push the ground and pull the rope. After struggling for another 20 minutes, I reached the peak. And after giving out a sigh of relief, I realized that things have started to make sense to me. That lecture, that penultimate judgment that the sir gave us about why we need to receive, we need to give forces around the elements around us, is to receive the forces which will move us in the direction we want. If I had not given those forces around the elements present around me during that mountain climb, I would have never received the forces necessary to climb me up the peak. Similarly, in a very similar fashion, if we all in our life were to move in the right direction, then it is very important for us to push away the toxic people and the toxic activities that we all are involved in our life. And at the same time, we are supposed to pull the bad opportunities that come across in our life and thus move forward in the correct direction. Thanks.
That was a real example of this experience. Next we have the next session, the table topic session. I would like to call upon the table topic masters of the question summary to take up on the stage on the table topic.
Well, time passes in a jiffy, isn't it? From your parents' baby, you become someone else's baby. And I still remember when I was a child, I dreamt of becoming a cricketer. Then, when I was studying in my 8th class, I had a dream of working in NASA. Now, let's not discuss what is my dream now. With this, I want you to focus on one thing. How time has changed. Like earlier, when the love letters were passed, people relied on pigeons. Now people are relying on WhatsApp. Now what has changed in this scenario? Earlier, there are two things that have changed. The communication speed has increased over time and will increase. But on the other hand, we have lost our patience. Earlier, people used to have a lot of patience. And we, as a youth, we don't have any patience. With this, let me start the table topic session. In a table topic session, there will be a participation of both Toastmasters and guests, and they will be invited here to speak on a topic for around 1 to 2.5 minutes. You all, if you are invited, you will get 30 seconds to think about that topic, and then you have to start. To qualify for the best speaker, you have to give at least 1 minute and at max 2.5 minutes. So with this, let me start the first. So I want to ask, does anyone wants to volunteer?
Among guests
or Toastmasters? Like we have very few, so I think all have to come. So who comes first? That's the you come first.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters. The topic I have given is the best days of my life. So, as everyone would agree, the best days of any person's life is their childhood. And specifically during the childhood period, the summer vacations. Summer vacations are just the best. We can play cricket in the afternoon, eat mangoes, roam around with friends, go to relatives' house and chill with cousins. So for me too, the summer vacation during my childhood were the best days of my life. But as time changes, as Postmaster Swami said, time passes in a jiffy. And right now my days and my summer vacations are passed doing projects with professors or learning of machine learning or learning of Python to have a good job prospects. So I would conclude my speech by saying that this is during my childhood.
Thank you so much, Kavish. Well, if you ask me this question, I'll say that during this vacations, I had to spend two weeks with two little children, maybe I should say infants. Like they were 1.5 years old. So I had to spend 2 weeks with them. It was such wonderful. Like kids have innocence. Like we spend time with them, we learn them. If you have to learn really, you can even learn from a kid. So with this, now I will invite the second Toastmaster Vishwas.
It so happens that when I look back at my 11th and 12th, so I always feel like if I had studied a bit harder and concentrated more on JE, then it was JE that time. So I was the last batch to write JE, so to give JE. So if I had studied a bit more harder, then maybe I would have done my BTEC from an IIT. I feel bad, but then look, I'm here in IIT today as a student. So that compensates for whatever, you know, at some other point I realize that I should work hard and then, yeah. So apart from that, the moral of the story is basically like every single time you feel that you should have done that at that point in time, I say it's never too late. You always get enough opportunities, and opportunities keep knocking at your doors. So it just takes hard work and whatever to just make use of it and realize whatever you wanted to back then and leave your dreams. So that's
wonderful. Really, you know what I would have changed? I would change my habit of sleeping 12 hours in my graduation. So with this, now I'd like to invite Toastmaster. I will do my name. So Neha, this is an interesting topic. Your learnings in IIT so far. Toastmaster.
They get irritated of what I'm trying to say. apply, and till now I have learned a lot being in IIT in dorms. I have started observing people, how they express themselves, and how to be with, how to make friends, how to express what you are going through, or emotional anything personal, how to talk to people, and how to be more extrovert about things. So these are my learnings from IIT till now. And also
what I have learned in 3 months is riding a bicycle. So just let's invite.
Neharika, a beach vacation versus a mountain vacation, which one would you choose?
Last thing I want is a beach vacation. Okay, so let's call Toastmaster. So Toastmaster Jeevan, difference between your time graduation and between your time graduation and undergraduation. Undergraduation and post.
Main difference is obviously the number of girls surrounding me. So, at any point there were at least 10-15 girls surrounding me during my undergraduation. Here hardly there are zero or none. So the other difference, I think life was way more fun back then because of less pressure and more of friends, and there was a lot of hanging out to do. Whereas here I'm stuck with only assignments and again midnight assignments. So I hardly watch movies nowadays. Even movies become more of trailers when I watch them. Compress three hours movie into half an hour and watch them some more. And other things is I miss my family. Back in Bangalore when I used to stay with the family, and right now I'm stuck here alone. Family has become more of postulates and assignments as well. So, but I think back then there are very less opportunities for me, and compared to what I have right now, I mean there is so much of ground which I can look forward to in my stay in IIT. There is placements, then there is PhD, then there is also entrepreneurship and even postmasters, for example. I mean the opportunities here are limitless actually. I mean, there is so much of growth here, and I didn't have that back in my undergraduation. Even though there are a lot of people and a lot more social activities, I still didn't grow as a person, because I mean when you're surrounded with people, you just become you want to grow. As I mean, the growth occurs only when you stay alone for some time, and that's where true growth comes by going and exploring out unexplored territories. So I think that's the main difference in my undergraduation graduation. back to you.
Thank you for talking. Very insightful. You know what I am searching between graduation? I was searching for a girl in the graduation. Now I am searching for myself. So now let's call.
Hello Toastmasters and welcome guests. It really happens to me that I meet someone unexpectedly, or you can say by bolt from the blue. But let me share you a story, like it's from the perspective of some other guy. So I was working near Vadodara, and I used to fill the forms of various PSUs and AMCAD and all those kind of companies, and all the centers usually fall in the city of Vadodara. So I took the train at the night and reached at the in the morning at 5 o'clock. Took an auto, went to the center, exam center, gave my exams and came back. Now it just so happens that in the second half I have exams for another company, pretty much in the surrounding area of my first like center. And I was talking to this guy, this auto rickshaw, like, would you take me to so and so place? And like, it took about 30 seconds at me and asked me, why you're joking? I recently took you half an hour ago to the same place. How can you come back so quickly? Like, he was mistaking me with someone else. And he was not ready to like acknowledge that I am a different person. So this happened very rarely with me, and I like the memory is very crisp in my mind, because it never happens that a person of my height and same body structure plus same face and like encountered the auto rickshaw at the same time for the same day. So I think that's the weird and unexpected thing that happened to me over a few years.
Now, wearing a specs and keeping so much weird, if I don't give a sermon, then there's not a justice. So, today's theme is time. So, with time I have learned this, that in life, our ultimate objective is to reduce our regrets that we have related to our past. With this, now I would like to hand over the control to TA Modi of the day, Toastmaster Dheeraj.
Thank you, sir. So
That was a wonderful session, first question is over. Next we'll go to the next part of the Toastmasters meeting. The evaluation system. Today we had one humorous speech, for that we will not have any evaluation. Next we had a prepared speech by Toastmasters Dinesh, and the evaluator for the speech is Toastmasters Pranshu. So I would like to ask Pranshu to tell what was the agenda for the, what was the learning points for this speech, and also give the evaluation for this, for the prepared speech by Dinesh. Over to the first question.
Thank you, Toastmasters Dinesh. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, today my target speaker, Toastmasters Dinesh, took his first project from Pathways Level 1, so a good round of applause for him. Coming to you, since this is your first speech, I would like to mention that your confidence was very great. Like, you are never felt uncomfortable with the stage, you're comfortable with the audience, and your voice was very crisp and very clear. The words that you use, the pronunciation and enunciations, and they're very easy to understand. So look, you have complete awareness of the audience. That's the one great thing. Also, the style of your speech is, I would say it's storytelling slash some moral teaching to that. So that's great. Coming to your body language, like the use that you use, the board as a prop, right? So that was again great. It helps the audience to have a clear picture of what you're going through in that story. So that's a visual and audio cue to the audience, which is a great bonus point in any speech. The eye contact was also very great. Like you were not fixated at one audience. You were gaze was around this table. So your appointment was with each and every member of the audience. And again, like the vocal variety was there at times. So this is your first speech. I'm not going to be too harsh on that. We'll cross that bridge when that time comes, because I think in the subsequent projects you will have different targets in each speech. So that will be dealt with then. The content was interesting to me. I think you gave two stories, right? And through those two stories, you gave a little glimpse of your personality and the various life teaching and life lessons that you had until now. So coming back to like the shortcomings that I felt, since this is your icebreaker speech, we ought to know a little bit more about you, because we knew a little bit about you, but what are your hobbies, what Dinesh would like, you know what I'm trying to say, like, that somehow I felt that that's not clearly dealt with in this. But like, since you have a free hand in your icebreaker speech, you can modify your content according to your will, but if you give more about yourself, because here we know who you are, if you are in some other Toastmaster club where people come from different backgrounds, they might not know about you. So at that time, if you give your little bit more info about yourself, that would be much better. All in all, it was a good speech. Like, you are already in a high pedestal as a first speaker. I hope that in the subsequent speeches, you will be giving more interesting topics on more interesting content with greater respect and clarity.
Thank you,
Mr.
So we had prepared speech, we had those table topics, and we also had evaluation. So now we have a general evaluator who will come and do the evaluation of the entire speech. This is exactly. I call up the general evaluator first question.
So how to do the evaluation for the entire meeting? First, I would like to call upon Kavish to read out our comments.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. So today my duty as an accounter was to keep track of the fillers, of the different fillers. Starting with the prepared speech session, I'll start with Jeevan's speech, Toastmaster Jeevan's speech. Toastmaster Jeevan used "ah" 6 times in his speech and "ya" a single time. Coming to Toastmaster Dinesh, he used "ah" 6 times again and had one long pause in his speech. Coming to the table topic session, I couldn't keep track of my speech, but I start with Toastmaster Vishwas. He used A once, and twice, so thrice, and Ya three times. Toastmaster Neha, you used two times, and two times, so two times, and Ya one time. Toastmaster Niharika, you used so three times, one time, and had one long pause during your speech. Coming to Toastmaster Jeevan, you used and two times, so one time, one time, and I mean two times. Toastmaster Dinesh had a perfect speech. I couldn't find any errors in that. Coming to Toastmaster Pranshu, he used so two times and like three times. Coming to the evaluation session, again by Toastmaster Pranshu, he used a single time and one time and like two times. That's my report. Over to you.
Thank you, Pranshu. Now I'd like to call upon the time for today's meeting, Toastmaster.
Thank you, General Evaluator, fellow Toastmasters and guests. For the prepared speech section, Toastmaster Jeevan took 5 minutes and 59 seconds. Toastmaster Dinesh took 5 minutes and 7 seconds. Moving on to table topic speech, Toastmaster Kavish took 59 seconds. Toastmaster Vishwas took 1 minute and 35 seconds. Toastmaster Neha took 137 seconds. Niharika took 1 minute and 8 seconds. Toastmaster Jeevan took 2 minutes and 12 seconds. Toastmaster Dinesh took 1 minute and 9 seconds. Toastmaster Pranshu took 1 minute and 55 seconds. For the evaluation, evaluator Pranshu took 3 minutes and 3 seconds. Over to you.
So we have been given slips, right? So on that, you can vote for the best table topic speaker. So you had people come. I hope you know about their names. It's written there. And you recognize them by face, right? So if you want, I can just. So yeah, Kavish, that's Kavish. Vishwas, Neha, Niharika, Jeevan, Dinesh, that's Dinesh, and Pranshu. So whosoever speech you found it impressive, you can both write their names. Okay. And then the next would be for now you can write the names for the best table topics.
Maybe the best
table topics. The best table topics speaker. Which you found the best.
Just write TT and write. So, coming to the grammarian's report, today the word of the day was Jiffy, and we had Toastmaster Somai and Kavish use the word of the day once each. Dinesh, in your speech, you had phrases like "penultimate and judgment," and also the best one was "remains etched in my brain." So that was a good usage of phrase. And Neha, in your PP, you had words like "introvert" and "extrovert," which people don't usually use it. So good that you use it. So kudos on that. Pranshu, you had many phrases like out of the blue, memory is very crisp, high pedestal, so good phrases. Coming to suggestions, as in corrections, there was a statement said, explain me, it should have been explained it to me in that context. Actually very broad, actually broad, very might not be needed at that point. And left side of me, to my left, it should have been to my left. Went to a psychologist, I think psychiatrist would have been a better word there. And in table topics,
I had very long sentences which I could have replaced it with smaller sentences. That is my report as a grammarian. Coming to my report as a general evaluator, today for the first time we tried having a meeting on a Saturday that's 4 to 5, and I think we have met that. We are finishing it on time, we satisfying this day. And one thing is that when someone uses word of the day, please applaud. I mean the grammarian, I forgot to inform that, so you just have to applaud when someone uses word of the day, because it takes, it's quite difficult to use something, the word that's just thrown at you and just before the meeting, and you'll have to come up with a sentence using that word, so please applaud. And coming to the table topics, Niharika, I like your take on mountain trek or the beach vacation, the way you said, like, you would enjoy a beach vacation, but then you would like to conquer your fears by going on a mountain trek. And Neha, you said you are an introvert, you find it difficult to talk to people, but the way you spoke for a minute and a half here, I didn't think that you can't talk in front of people. You did it very well, so keep talking in front of people, which I'm pretty sure you can improve it today. And Jeevan, you started with a topic which you started with girls, and then suddenly you took a U-turn and went on the philosophy and how it's like life changes, so good. Dinesh, thank you for busting the myth that residence is better, it's not equal to Chaitanya. So I thought that residence was equal to Chaitanya when it comes to meeting students. Pranshu, they say that there are 7 people like us in the world, so maybe one of those 7 was at that point in time very well. So that was about the table topics. Coming to the speech, Dinesh, you were amazing for your first speech project. As Pranshu pointed it out, we started it on a high register, so yeah, all the best and keep going. That's it from my side as a general evaluator. So coming to the next set of voting, so you can vote for the tag team from anyone among the three. You can vote for Kavish, our counter, you can vote for Kavish, Taino, Pranshu, and Gramini. So you can just write TAG tag. You have seen them give the reports, right? So whichever of you has the good report, you can just go for any other. And then the next set of voting would be for the role players, which would be the table topics master, that would be Toastmaster Somnath. If you love the topics that you gave, you can go for Somnath. And then we had the moderator for today's meeting, that is Deeraj. You can go for Deeraj. Or then it's the general evaluator, that is Sumit. So if you like the general evaluator report.
So time is a great equalizer, correct? Be it rich or poor, everyone has 24 hours. What you do with that is entirely up to you. But at the end, when you finally pass on the baton to your future generation, posterity as we say. What you make of your time, that defines your legacy. So being Toastmaster, it's one of our tenets to have time management as our core pillar. And we tried to change something today from say 2 hours to like 1 hour, and also we changed the timing. So far like we had done great, but we can always do better. I think we started 5 minutes late today. We can try to correct that in the subsequent meetings, and I think we are finishing, let's say, 10 minutes late. So we'll try again until we get things right here. And I hope like you guys enjoyed today's meeting. So can we have feedbacks from the guests, like what do you like about the meeting and what do you want us to change in the future? We'll get back to you after the meeting regarding the memberships. And it's organized like we like to improve better, and it's a collective effort of the whole team that goes behind the whole organization and the presiding of this meeting. And I think kudos to the POPONI today's Toastmaster leaders. So we took change very and trying to stick to the schedule. It's a big change, I believe, but I think later on, like, people will get used to it and we will do much better in subsequent meetings. And do we have the results? For Toastmaster, the best Toastmaster speech is Pranshu, that is me. So, it's difficult to give myself a prize. So. Best role player goes to Toastmaster Soumen. The best tag goes to Toastmaster Vishwas. If you guys have any queries regarding the membership, you can always contact me after the meeting, and I think one of us will probably talk to you. And, with this, I declare the meeting 173rd.